under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While the deep boating full time, you floating under the sea. Under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While the deep boating full time, you floating under the sea.
Oh, you're gonna be ethics, stewardship, and care.
I know, Dad, I know.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault. I mean, we were about to come back right away, and then the seagull kept going on and on and on about human stuff and people things.
Humans? Seagulls? You went up to the surface?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians.
Dad, they're not barbarians.
They're dangerous. Harpoons. Nets. You're my youngest.
I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my reef, you shall obey by my rules.
You just listen to me this once.
You shall never go back up to the surface again.
You're
understood?
There.
Such a stubborn little barnacle.
Be dangerous. Give him an inch and they swim all over you. Nonsense, if you ask me, you haven't been told. friend.
Eliel, down here is your home. The human world is a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there.
Lightning.
Hurricane's coming, Captain!
from the surf, and she was singing.
Calm down. We must get back to the kingdom.
No, I must find her and thank her for saving my life.
You get a good night's rest and you'll be as good as new.
No, I must... I swear she was real.
Thank you. friends.
Oh, don't be shy, Ariel, darling.
I shouldn't be here. Mother died because of you.
Oh, child, what happened to your dear mother was a terrible, unfortunate accident.
An accident?
But of course, I did my very best to save her.
My father told me that.
The truth is, the ocean wasn't big enough for both your father and I, so he sent me here. And now I see he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling. We're so very alike, you and I, gals with ambition. Now, tell me absolutely everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
A prince I hear. Quite a catch. Well, the answer is simple. You've got to become a human yourself.
Do that?
My dear, sweet child. That's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rain them across the goals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint. To those poor, unfortunate souls! I've been a spell to turn you into a human for 3 days. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Quincy to kiss you. If you do, you'll be a human forever.
And if I don't?
Well, you turn back into a mermaid and your soul will be mine forever. Life's full of tough choices, and then. And now, there's one more thing to discuss. My feet.
But I don't have any.
I'm not asking for much. Just your voice.
My voice? But if I don't have my voice, how can I ever?
Well, you have your looks! Your pretty face! And don't underestimate the importance of body language!
Don't tell me.
used to think a hopper. Your hairdo's different. No? Well, I can't quite put my foot on it right now.
She's got legs, you idiot.
Ariel trained her voice to become human.
No, kid, not your beautiful pipes.
Yes, see? What a sound. What would her father say? I tell you what her father would say. He'd say he's gonna kill himself a crab. That's what he'd say.
Uh-huh. Well, now Ariel has 3 days to make the prince fall in love with her.
Oh, the prince?
Well, I'll say.
Hey, what have we got here? Shoo, shoo. Miss, are you all right? Why, you look so familiar. Well, it's you. I've been looking for you everywhere. What's your name? Sore throat, huh? Oh, you don't speak at all? I'm sorry. Well, I've got just the remedy. Let's go back to my palace and I'll make you a hot meal and a warm bath.
Oh. Get it, Ariel! Yeah!
That's what I call bringing you in!
Now I've got to follow her. This is gonna get me in real hot water.
What's up with that guy? What a crap.
Can't say I blame you. That's an antique from dusk to dawn.
sorry, old friend. It looks like your pipe smoked you.
Yes, very amazing. You know, she says that it can make you smile.
Come along, Grimsby. Let's leave the young ones alone for a bit.
You should see the princesses Grimsby usually brings in here. So prim, so boring, but you. Yo, don't mind my asking. What was it? An accident when you were small? Oh, I didn't mean it like that. I mean, words can mean... A smile can mean way more than words. You're nimble on your feet, aren't you? Well, allow me to teach you a dance. That voice, it's been haunting me. Well, anyways, I should let you go get some sleep. Good night.
Out of the frying pan, into the fire, the things I do for you, young lady. Now I should just mark straight back home to your father. So you can be miserable the rest of your life. It's true, I've got no backbone.
All right, kid, I'm in.
But we've got to get that boy to kiss you before it is too late. So here's a few tips to a clever grab to a little mermaid. First, you gotta bat your eyes like this. Then you gotta pucker your lips like this. Oh, that's good! You put those two things together tomorrow and you got that boy in the palm of your hand.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la, blow down on you, listen to the song. The song said, kiss the girl.
I have to marry a princess before sunset, or else.
Give her back to me.
Not on your life.
It so happens that your daughter made a bargain, swapped her voice to land a man up where it's dry. Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable, unless.
Unless.
There is a little something we could try. Yes, perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own. Make this deal and set her free, or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone.
It's not my soul you want, it's my power.
Now, which would you rather be, the king of the sea or a father to his little girl?
Takes a great responsibility to handle such a beautiful trident.
Nonsense, Tripod, hand it over. Finally, the ocean belongs to me! And now you poor unfortunate souls! And now you poor unfortunate souls! Time's up! You're through! Now the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole. All the power of the trident and the shell in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shore! Now see for yourself how banishment feels! You poor unfortunate
you.
great waiter, take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Up in the sun, they slave away. While they keep putting water on your day. Under the sea. Yes. Darling, it's better. Come here, it's waiter, take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Thank you.